Hello friends, once again welcome to TechVedas. Friends, this video is in the continuation of our discussion on GPIO. So if you have not watched the previous video, watch that first. So in summary, in part 1 we had discussed how GPIO looks inside your microcontroller, its input and output mode, and what is a floating or high impedance state, and how it can result in higher power consumption due to the leakage current. So now in this video, let's continue our discussion on this topic and try to understand what is the need of pull-up and pull-down resistor while making use of GPIO and some of the most commonly used GPIO output configurations. So let's start. So this is something which we had already talked about. Each GPIO pin consists of two buffers. One is for input and other is for output. And a buffer is a circuit which consists of two CMOS transistors connected in this fashion. And we also know that all GPIOs are by default configured in input mode with floating or high impedance state. But if we configure it in output mode, the default state for output mode is push-pull. Let's see what push-pull is. Push-pull uses both PMOS and NMOS transistors in its configuration. Let's see how to operate an LED in push-pull configuration. To turn on the LED, we can write 1. So due to this inverter logics, PMOS transistor will be turned on and NMOS will be turned off, which means the LED is pulled to VCC and in result it will be turned on. Here I am also using a current limiting resistor just to limit the current flowing in the LED to protect it from the higher current flow. And to turn off the LED, we can write 0, which will turn off the PMOS transistor and turn on the NMOS. In result, LED will be pulled to ground. So I hope by now push-pull configuration is clear and how to operate an LED in this configuration. Now let's talk about one more important configuration, open drain. This configuration is quite different from push-pull. As in push-pull, we were using both transistors. But in open drain, only one NMOS transistor will be active. You can treat it like PMOS transistor is not at all present. So in this configuration, if transistor is turned on, the output is pulled to ground. But if this transistor is turned off, the output is simply floating. It's neither connected to VCC nor to ground. So means with the open drain configuration, we can achieve output either pulled to ground or kept floating, which is not at all useful in any application. Great, so now we understood what open drain configuration is and what are its various states. To make use of this configuration, we need to provide pull-up capability, which leads us to our next discussion, open drain with pull-up resistor. So here are the two pictures of open drain configuration. One with internal pull-up and other is with external pull-up. Internal pull-up can be activated by configuring GPIO control resistors. Now let's try to understand open drain configuration with pull-up resistors by operating an LED. If we write 1, which will in turn turn off the NMOS transistor, an LED will be pulled to VCC and hence will be turned on. And if we write 0, the NMOS transistor will be turned on and the LED will be pulled to ground and hence will be turned off. So by this way, we can control the output of an open drain configuration. We had also discussed this configuration while talking about I2C protocol. I recommend you to check out that video also for more information on this configuration. So that's all I have in this video. I hope the content of this video is helpful for you. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.